Welcome to the Best Coast Shire Council Report, your weekly update on council news and events.
Hi, I'm Lauren Grills.
And I'm Steve Fury.
Welcome to this week's show where we'll be talking about lost pets, works happening in Inverloch, the land management rebate, but first, Bass Coast has received a much needed boost for sports and recreation.
That's right, Lauren, the Wonthaggi Netball Courts Renewal and Thompson Reserve Ground Lighting Project have received $100,000 each. Now, this money comes from the Community Sports Infrastructure Fund, and it means that these two long-awaited projects can now go ahead. These two grants are in addition to Council's own contributions of $557,400 for the netball courts and $92,500 towards Thompson Reserve Lighting, not to mention a significant amount of fundraising that has been done by passionate local sporting clubs.
The Wonthaggi Netball Courts are used by the Wonthaggi and District Netball Association and the Wonthaggi Power Football Netball Club. Together they've raised $100,000 to renew their courts. The seven courts are in such poor condition that they aren't suitable for hosting finals matches. The improved courts will not only raise the profile of netball within Bass Coast, but lift the standard of facilities at the Wonthaggi Recreation Reserve.
We've also worked closely with the Inverloch Stars Soccer Club on their $260,000 project so the club can train at Thompson Reserve under lights. Now, currently, the lack of lighting means that the players have to travel away from Inverloch to use the oval lighting at either Wonthaggi or Inverloch football grounds. And let's face it, soccer grounds and football grounds are different shapes. And also, a lot of their equipment would be stored back at Thompson Reserve. So it's a huge morale boost for the club as they'll all be able to both train and play at the club's home ground.
The Stars have also been busy fundraising and will contribute $70,000 to the project. These grants really are a great example of partnerships between our community and local and state governments. Council has also received $30,000 towards the development of the Municipal Recreation Plan. This document will set out the direction and support the development of recreation facilities and services for the next decade. The $60,000 plan will promote more participation, shared and multi-use facilities, and will be a key supporting document for Council in seeking external funding.
Now, while we're talking about Inverloch, we've recently mentioned on this show that we'll be starting work on the Eyre Creek pedestrian bridge and the shared path from Abbott Street to Eyre Creek. Now, all this was scheduled to be finished in August, and the starting point for these works is the bridge. But as it turns out, we need a piling contractor, you know, the pile drive the posts deep into the ground. Anyway, the piling contractor now isn't available until late July, and as a result, the delay means the bridge should be finished in August and the shared pathway in September, so a slight delay.
Still in Inverloch, the last several years have been harsh on the foreshore opposite Grandview Grove. If it's left, this erosion will claim even more land, including the overflow car park from the boat ramp, a grassed open space and a roadway. So later this month, we'll be building an 80-metre rock seawall, installing new drainage infrastructure, removing old concrete pipes and cleaning up rubble and deadwood from the beach.
It's a good chance to clean up a high-profile area of the Anderson Inlet foreshore. And while this is going on, part of the foreshore will need to be closed to the public, but we've timed the works deliberately for the quieter winter period and at a time when the overflow boat ramp car parking isn't needed. Money-wise, the project cost us just over $101,000, which is jointly funded through a council contribution of $90,000 and a state government grant of $11,200 from the Coastal Environments Program.
We're starting a review of the land management rebate policy. This is a rebate on rates for rural property owners who are eligible and have done work on their farms that qualify for the rebate. These works could include the control of noxious weeds, pest animals and soil erosion, as well as planting new vegetation or protecting what's already there, controlling salinity and protecting waterways.
The aim of the policy is to encourage and reward rural property owners for good land management. Around 80% of Bass Coast is farmland and around 55% of eligible property owners apply for the rebate. So that's about 1,400 properties all up, and last year we had 800 applicants. So in the next couple of weeks, we'll be asking for feedback as to how the policy's working and how it could be further improved.
We'll have more on this topic next week, but for now you can find more information at basscoast.vic.gov.au/LMR. And that's all we've got time for this week. As always, if you have any questions or need more information about anything we've mentioned, give us a call on 1300 BCoast. That's 1300 226 278 or 03 5671 221, and keep up to date on our Facebook page at facebook.com/Bass Coast Shire or follow us on Twitter on @BassCoast. Catch you next week for more council news.
The Bass Coast Shire Council Report is broadcast on Tuesday mornings at 9:30, Thursday afternoons at 4:30, and on Saturday mornings at 10 on your community station 3MFM. Audio and transcript is also available from our website, basscoast.vic.gov.au.